Hi, this is Chris, the GMAT expert at Magoosh, and today I'm going to give you a high-level overview of the GMAT math section, including the different question types as well as the concepts tested on the exam. So let's talk about those concepts. First up is arithmetic. We'll have fractions, percents, squares, square roots. Next up is algebra. You'll have variables, sometimes more than one, and you'll have to solve for those variables. Next up, we have geometry. Squares, circles, triangles, trapezoid. Can you find the area, perimeter, or circumference? And the last concept we have, integer properties. This is where we'll have divisibility, factors, prime numbers, least common multiples, all that good stuff. Now that we've gone through the concepts, the what, let's talk about the how. So these are the question types on the GMAT, starting with problem solving, which is your basic five answer choices, one of which is correct. The second type is data sufficiency, and this is where things get complicated. Sure, you'll have five answer choices, one of which is correct, but now you'll be analyzing two statements, and your job is to determine if each of them gives you enough information to answer a question. Oh, and by the way, you'll also have to determine whether both of them together give you enough information to answer the question. I know, pretty complicated. That was the how and the what. But don't go just yet. I have other important information about the GMAT math section, starting with the number of questions. You will have 31 questions and you'll have to answer them in 62 minutes, which means exactly 2 minutes per question. Next important thing is there is no calculator, so you really have to fine-tune those mental math muscles. But you will get scratch paper. Now that you're familiar with the basics, let's talk about next steps. Here are my top three Magoosh resources. First, you'll want to figure out where you are in your GMAT journey. And to do so, take a GMAT diagnostic test. This will help you find and focus on those areas that need the most work. Second, you'll want to learn how to prepare for the test. I recommend learning strategies for each question type and sticking to a study schedule. Finally, check out our How to Study for the GMAT Math blog post, where you'll find plenty of tips and strategies. You can find links to all the resources I mentioned in the description below.